I want you to take this journey with me. Let's set the stage. It's a Sunday in Baltimore. It could be kids in a park wearing Druid Hill. They're watching dirt bike riders go past, do tricks, pop wheelies, do stunts. It's zipping. You can hear the engines revving, smell the gasoline. You can see the joy and excitement in their face. Someone's probably learning how to fix their dirt bike because the parts are way too expensive to buy. Then they can go to school. They can get a pop quiz or a test from a teacher. You know the kind we all heard and we've all hated. A train that's leaving from New York goes to Cleveland, but they're here in Baltimore. How does this relate? They don't get it. They failed the test, and now they can hate school. Then their world can be turned upside down. They can get on Facebook, on Instagram, get a call or a text. They can watch as their friend can become a hashtag. A kid in the wrong place at the wrong time, lost to the streets, lost to the system, or lost to gun violence. Or a kid that could be arrested for a dirt bike. Because in my city, it can be a misdemeanor for possession of a dirt bike. This can be a likely story for Black kids across the country. In cities like Miami, Cleveland, Atlanta, Philly, whatever place had the dirt bike task force. Now ask yourself, if the thing you used to relieve your stress, if it was demonized, would you still do it? If it was criminalized? The answer is yes. That's the reality for Black people across the U.S. right now. They've watched as we made room in cities for skateboarders, for bicyclists, and any other sport. They can watch TV and see it on X Games, the Olympics, on ESPN. The style of riding can be seen in ad campaigns and films. But in Baltimore, what do they have to look forward to? What do riders get from all of it? No space, no outlet, just a typical narrative. Like I said, this is a common story. I was a kid in the park. I wanted to be just like the big dirt bike riders, but I hate the fall. Instead, I became like Bill Nye the Science Guy. I was doing all kinds of experiments, blowing my eyebrows off, gluing people to the chair, and I may or may not have made stink bombs in school. They would describe me as another bad kid. What they didn't see was all my genius, my talent. My voice was not heard. Then I became that Black girl from West Baltimore working in STEM. My first position, I was confused for the secretary. I was pissed. But it lit a fire in me, so when I get more people in the industry. And in 2013, that's what I started doing, working in small groups with kids and students, teaching them STEM activities. Then in 2014, I lost my little brother to the prison system. In 2015, I lost all faith in the system, period. The world watched, following the Freddie Gray uprising as Baltimore burned. I wondered, when were people going to listen? Where were the solutions? And where was the investment into my community? In 2016, I broke the system and became the founder and CEO of B360, carving out a new lane. I went back to my experience in the park. I thought about the kids fixing their bikes. Those are skills people use to pay the bills, just like mechanics and mechanical engineers. We leaned into STEM, S, science. The science behind popping the best wheelie, putting your dirt bike at 12 o'clock, is a physics equation. T, technology. The technology needed to get the best radial tires so you don't have frictional asphalt. E, engineering. The engineering needed to fix or repair your dirt bike, but to also get the best mat noise. M, mathematics. The math needed for the gas to oil ratio so your dirt bike does not explode. Then I took it a step further. I thought about the riders. I knew the only way to have programming solutions was to have them at the table. Because the people closest to the problem are the solution. I thought about Mike. Since he was 6, he's been riding dirt bikes. When he was 17, graduating high school, he didn't know what he wanted to do, but he knew he loved everything about dirt bikes. He started working with us in B360. He's helped us educate kids, train dirt bike riders, and at 21, he's our lead instructor. He's created events, he's traveled across the country, and he really represents the best of B360. At the core of our work is constantly thinking about what people like Mike want. For Mike, he wants a space. A space where he can keep working with students on our curriculum, a space where he can keep training more riders and growing their skill sets, a space where he no longer has escape, but he has something in his own city for him. With your support and the support of more cities, we can make this a reality. Since 2017, we've saved the city of Baltimore about $233 million by doing programming for over 7,000 students. We've saved the city of Baltimore $1 million by growing workforce and opportunities for people just like Mike. That's less people that could possibly go to jail, less money spent on dollars and cents of incarceration, and more money going back into our Black communities, our leaders, our culture, and our voices. We don't need your Black squares, we don't need your campaigns, but what we do need is your dollars and cents behind us to make real change. We need more people like you and cities to believe and invest in us in our model of growing the people. What will you choose to be? An ally? Be an impact? Be the revolution? Be 360. Thank you.